So I used to go to a church youth group, and the workers there were really inspirational and kind of almost like second parents, really. So when I got to 18, I was too old to go to the youth club, so they kind of made me a junior leader to try and extend me going. And from then, I guess 10 years later, I just, the way those guys were with us and the opportunities they give us just made me want to help people myself.
When I did get to meet him, he came down the first time, was my second time here. He sort of blew me away a little bit. He's inspirational, and he was sort of, the young people looked up to him, and he was like a breath of fresh air coming in, and I could see why the young people looked up to him. He was just so energetic and so lively, and it was just great to see. And somebody who was just starting out being a youth worker, I wanted to be, I sort of thought, well, if I can be anything like that, then I'll be, you know, if half that good, I'll be happy with myself. So
seeing the young people transformed or in the process of transforming is just everything. It's why we do the job, and I say we because, again, I'm just blessed to be part of a great team, and the fact that the rest of the team shares with me this need for wanting to change young people's lives and give them the opportunities and give them something that they can go on to do, it's just priceless.
I had a young lad that came to me when he was off and said, you know, I'm struggling to make friends, you know, he couldn't get a job, and he was really struggling, so I came down, I made him with cups of tea and got him speaking and stuff, and then he found him a job in France.
We found an international opportunity for one of the most difficult, hard to reach young men who we met 5 years ago, and he's actually at the moment in France volunteering with YMCA La Rochette, getting paid, living the dream.
And we pushed him, and Eddie sat down and did his CV with him and got him out of that shell and saying, you can do this and you can. And even after he'd gone, he had a first couple of weeks that was tough. You know, he was on the email and stuff, you know, encouraging him, saying, you know, you can do it, we know you can.
He wrote a blog the other day, and it's an absolutely totally different guy from when we met 5 years ago, when he was, you know, in his own words, a troublemaker and doing stuff he shouldn't have done, really. So it's about, for me, it's not just doing a project until the funding ends or a 12-week cycle. It's about being that constant support network and a place where young people can be.
I look at this guy now emailing, and he's changed his life completely, and I just think that's just one little thing that Eddie did, and he's changed his life completely around.
Isaac has been with us just under a year now, and he came on as a modern apprentice youth worker. And it's been fascinating to watch him develop from quite a shy, quiet boy to this young man that's really, really confident in working with young people.
Part of my nature was, you know, helping people. I just didn't really know the right way to go about it. And as soon as I started doing the sort of practical sides to it, I started to really enjoy it. And when I started seeing the change in some of the young people and how the other colleagues had made a change in the young person, it looked, you know, it felt pretty good as well. So I just really, really wanted to help people, so I thought I'd take that route.
He has a natural affinity with them. He really, really engages them, even some of the more difficult young people that we work with here.
If we're having a problem or something, he's always there to talk to him. Gives a better perspective of what we would normally do to something that's reasonable to do. Mm-hmm. Like before I started here, I'd have probably been a violent, aggressive person, but he's always been there and said, listen, you just need to talk through your issues and do it that way instead of just lashing out and stuff like that. So he's just been a good role model, I think, really.
And when you work together, when you work with the challenging young people, you know, you see sometimes a totally different side to him, what a lot of people don't see, and it's just about bringing that side out. And you know, being able to do that, it is really beneficial for either me as well as a young person, because, you know, a lot of people do sort of label them, but, you know, we're a voice to say, you know, and we give them a voice as well to say to them, you know, you need to stand up for who you really are.
He's got a really bright future, and I've enjoyed watching his development from when he started all the way up to what I'd consider to be one of the best youth workers that I've certainly come across in Bradford.
There's nobody there for them. They have no one to go to talk to about their problems or situations, which, because they keep in a lot, it sort of affects them to a point where, you know, they just start head down the road of giving up, but we're here to, you know, to give them hope and self-belief by doing things with them.
Just tremendously impressed by his attitude and his work ethic. He's just really, really good, good to have around.
I didn't have an understanding of informal education until I'd done the YMCA George Williams degree. And I went to see my old youth worker where I rang him. He says, any chance of doing some voluntary work, I'm interested. And within seconds of the phone call, he was down to the workplace where I work, saying, yes, I wanted to come up tonight, and I ended up doing some voluntary work for a year.
Thomas had put himself through the George Williams College and gained a youth work degree. And he'd done that through distance learning and part-time learning. And for me, that shows a massive amount of personal commitment to your profession. If you're able to do that, as well as hold down your full-time job, he's also got three young kids, and he must be incredibly busy to do that. And that, automatically reading that on paper, kind of got him to the shortlist stage because he was well qualified. He was qualified through the YMCA, so he understood our approach to youth work. And he also had exactly the background of the community-based youth work that we provide.
One of my teachers actually told us I'd never amount to nothing, and that was so destroying for me. And I clean windows on a weekend as just something to do, and actually to this teacher's house. And he asked us how I was doing, and I told him I'd actually gained my degree in youth work. But I also done it because I wanted to see what was happening on the other side of the fence.
We appointed him, and he moved into a senior youth worker post in one of our community youth projects. And over the last 18 months, he's really been a real asset to us.
The kids that are with me, to be honest with you, only with us for 2 hours. So they've got them other 22 hours to go home and be around the role models that are around. But if I can make just one person come in here and just make them go out with a smile just by having a cup of tea with them and patting them on the back, then to me that's my job done. But I always try 110% to make them better than themselves, pat them on the back and say you're worth more than this.
It's very quickly clear that Thomas was able to engage very challenging young men who were very disengaged and build up a relationship of trust with them.
He says, but I can't change what the people think of us. I says, you can change what they think of you now, but not what they thought of you then. I said, maybe that'll go. But what you need to do is do something where you feel happy and the community can fit into it. And he's on stage one of the Key Fund, then stage two, then stage three, and then on stage four, he decided he wanted to do a community trip. He managed to go around the whole estate, ask where they wanted to go, worked out the sums, it'll cost you £5 now, raise the rest. You got sweet bags for the kids, pop, played bingo on the bus, and he organised all that through spending time and working with me, and he actually turned into become a youth worker.
Most outsiders wouldn't even see that process happening. They wouldn't notice that that's what Tom's able to do. But that's what he does, and he does it quietly, and he gets on with it. And he's brilliant at it.